My name is Ben Cohn. I'm an upcoming fifth year grad student in the biomedical sciences program here at UCSF. My PI's name is Shomi Sanjabi, so we're the Sanjabi lab. And we really work on understanding the immune response to HIV. So I have a bench where I would just kind of do stuff that involves non-infectious material. If I'm using virus, I would work in a biosafety cabinet, which is in a different room and has controlled ventilation. So definitely we take safety really seriously. And then there is a third location on another floor of this building where I go if I need to use the tools that are there. So it's definitely up and moving around a lot, which I love. I love it here because it's an open floor plan. So lab really just kind of refers to the group of people, but not really a physical location. So we have this big open space, and all the groups of people are occupy that space, but there aren't physical divisions between them. So you get a lot of dialogue between, honestly, between across all levels, you know, from postdocs, grad students, RAs, investigators will walk through. It's understanding something about how the world works, I think, is really satisfying. I think of it almost a little bit like archaeology, like the stuff, you know, is not, has been there, it's just waiting for us to figure it out. And then the cool part of that is that once you figure out how something works, people are really good at this. They like find something and they say, well, we could use it for this other thing. And then you potentially could make something that could help a lot of people. So it's knowledge, satisfaction in knowing something, but then also satisfaction in making something useful. Ultimately, I think is what at least life sciences is all about. You know, as a kid, I was very much an outdoor kid. I was collecting bugs and walking around outside, and that didn't really lead me to a career in, you know, ecology or anything like that. But I think just trying to understand the world, I think, was a big part of being a kid, really, for me and probably most kids. And my family, we have a lot of writers, actually. So, my mom and my brother both studied writing. My grandfather also was a reporter. My dad was a software engineer, but yeah, first biologist. there's a whole spectrum of jobs out there. So I mean, if you're a high schooler sitting there thinking, you know, I don't want to be some guy in a lab coat on a bench for the rest of my life, that is like this much of the world of science, basically. That's kind of the point, is that everyone's style is different. So just figure out what drives you personally, I think, and try to find out a way to make a life out of that. Take science classes in college. Make sure that you love it. It's, you know, it's different than taking tests and, you know, writing papers. It really is sort of a, being a good experimentalist on the bench, I think, is sort of a very, there's a lot of common sense involved, honestly. Like, so you have to kind of be a little practical also. We're trying to understand the immune system, right? So we would hope that the stuff that we discover can be used to make better, or really any vaccine for HIV, you know, prevent people from becoming infected in the first place. I know there are a lot of people working on this problem in the world, so I think ideally we'd, you know, like to fit into that in a meaningful way.